Water is the most precious natural resource on our planet, and without it, life on Earth would be non-existent. Half of humanity relies on the fresh water that accumulates in mountainous regions like the Himalayas. With glacier coverage of 33,000 square kilometers, the Himalayan region is aptly called the Water Tower of Asia, as it provides around 8.6 million cubic meters of water annually. Glaciers from this region mother several rivers and streams in the subcontinent, which support economy and the livelihood of millions of people. In several countries like China, India, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal, and Bangladesh. But one phenomenon is set to change the very lives of these people as well as the rest of the world, endangering their very existence. Humanity is about to face the most devastating catastrophe that mankind has encountered since the bubonic plague during the Middle Ages. Surely, this largest threat to humanity is global warming.
The first impact of the climate change or the global warming is seen on the cryosphere. What we mean by the cryosphere is that glaciers, permafrost, and the seasonal snow. So all the highlands of the world were affected, even the two poles, the Antarctica and the Arctic also affected. But in the last 100 years, the impact was not so enormous as we are seeing in the last 10, 15 years and 20 years, that the ice sheet is melting, the Western Antarctic ice sheet is collapsing. Similarly, the Arctic region is which is on the sea, is also melting fast. Greenland ice sheet is melting. The glaciers of the Pamir, Hindu Kush, Himalaya, Tibetan Plateau, and the Karakoram is melting.
Two decades back, global warming was considered a Western concept. But now, its impact is visible across the globe. Today, places as cold as Kashmir are also experiencing the heat of global warming. Jammu and Kashmir is unique in having more than 6% of land area under freshwater ecosystems that include subtropical lakes of Jammu, floodplain lakes of Kashmir Valley, high altitude Himalayan lakes, perennial rivers of the Indus system, wetlands of different dimensions, ponds, snow-fed streams, springs, reservoirs, etc. For the last 10 years, unusual rise in temperature has made an impact on the glacial reserves of Kashmir.
Yes, it is very much a fact that the global warming is evident in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, and it is evident in many sectors in the state of Jammu and Kashmir. If you look at the snow and glaciers, if we look at the water resources, if we look into the agriculture crops, particularly in the water resources sector, climate change, there are enough indicators for the climate change.
Glaciers in Jammu and Kashmir are receding at a faster rate compared to other glacial regions in the world.
This is called the Suru River. This glacier was extended up to this, the snout was here, and the glacier, this water was flowing under this glacier. Now, during these past about 30 years, now this snout has receded back. Now you see this position of this. It's not only the snout is only receding back. The mass of this particular area, the glacier, it was like the convex type of a glacier here. And the snout was totally vertical face. Now it has already become the tapering glacier. You can see it is a tapering now.
In Suru Basin alone, we have lost about 16% of glaciers in the last 40 years. Similarly, we have lost 18% of the Kolhai Glacier, the main source of drinking water and irrigation in the valley during the same period. Recently, Kashmir has been witnessing drastic decrease in the snowfall. This reduction in snowfall, together with the fast receding glaciers, has resulted in water scarcity for irrigation and hydropower generation in some seasons.
Barf yahan December se start hoti thi ya last 1st January se 6 foot 7 foot 8 foot barf barti thi fir rasta paidal jane ke niche nahi milte the to us barf ke sath jahan jo area tha ye bahut safe rehta tha aur makki darakhat meva sab cheez ban jati thi fir baad mein thodi thodi barish har time par hoti thi ap apne time par to yahan ka logon ko guzara maal mein mushkil mein zyada chalta tha ab jab ye mausam aa gaya to barf thodi girti hai yahan मौसम थोड़ा खुश है जैसे बारिश के मौसम आता है उस वक्त बारिश नहीं होती है जो फसल है वो जल जाती है खत्म हो जाती है उसमें फसल मेवा नहीं बन जाता है ना मक्की काई चीज नहीं बनती
Recently, Kashmir has been witnessing drastic changes in the precipitation and seasonal changes. The change is felt as most of the spring flowers like this narcissus that normally used to flower in March can now be seen in full bloom in January or February. The demarcation between seasons that was well defined a decade ago has vanished. It is now difficult to distinguish between spring and summer, as also between autumn and winter. Most of the plains in Kashmir used to remain under snow until early spring, but now plains even in winter are bereft of any white cover. The icicles were a common sight in Kashmir, but now they are seen only at higher altitudes. Another phenomenon that is directly related to global warming is the occurrence of high velocity storms in the valley, which have caused devastation to crops and fruits, thus affecting the livelihood of many people.
وٕنکیٚنَس چھُ اَتھ تاپھ لوٚگمُت یہِ چھُ گوٚمُت خراب یہِ حظ روزِ ییٚمہِ سۭتۍ وۄنۍ مال موٗجوٗد مال کُلِس پٮ۪ٹھ چھُ موٗجوٗد مال اَسہِ وٕنکیٚنَس یہِ کُلِس پٮ۪ٹھ اَسہِ چھُ اَتھ حظ گژھِ یی
Frequency of flooding has increased in the valley during the last few decades. Coupled with the unplanned urbanization and mismanagement of the Jhelum floodplains, the situation is going to be alarming in the near future. One can well imagine the future scenario, with most of the wetlands that used to act as sponge during flooding being urbanized and converted into concrete landscape. Most of our wetlands and water bodies are already fighting a lost battle for their survival. Wetland habitat, productivity and process being linked to the hydrological cycle and seasons are getting adversely affected due to seasonal changes in the precipitation and runoff. Most of the wetlands have less biodiversity in terms of fauna and flora compared to the situation about half a century ago. In the process, obnoxious weeds and other aquatic life have succeeded the most productive and useful biota. The migratory birds have changed their cycle. While some of them stay here even during the summer, others don't return even in winters. The waterfowl that used to migrate here during winter months stay here for most of the year. Some birds like the hoopoe, who were seen in flocks in spring, are hardly spotted. Many others, like the swallow, have completely disappeared. Rapid melting of the Kolhai Glacier, one of the largest glaciers of Kashmir Himalayas, has evoked concern among environmentalists who stress for immediate measures to at least minimize its melting rate. Kolhai has shrunk a staggering 18% during the past 3 decades due to unprecedented increase in temperature caused by high levels of pollution by the emission of greenhouse gases, by ever-increasing vehicles and cement plants. Besides increased human activity near the glacier, particularly the Gujars. The increase in the number of pilgrims in the eco-sensitive region around the Amarnath Shrine is also a reason for melting of this glacier.
Now you see, there is a lot of anthropogenic pressures there. A lot of people going to the pilgrimage, domestic pilgrimage, national pilgrimages are coming there. And for about 4 or 5 months, there is a huge human rush to that system, to the Leather Valley system. So that may have impacted some of these glaciers. So that is why we see 18% of Kolhai Glacier has been lost for the last 40 years.
Glaciers are an important source of fresh water in Kashmir. Any change in the temperature or precipitation influences the flow in the hydrological system of the valley. Lidar Valley covers an area of more than 1,200 square kilometers and it sustains about 48 glaciers, covering an ice-covered area of 39 square kilometers. It is important to establish an index glacier in this region for assessing the water resources availability to the communities in the valley. In Jammu and Kashmir, the Energy and Resources Institute, or TERI, has selected the Kolhai Glacier in the West Lidar Valley as one of the index glaciers for long-term monitoring.
We are planning to have this mass balance studies from the 2010 onwards. So we'll going slowly increasing the number of benchmark glaciers. So I hope that in the next 10-15 years, there will be lot many benchmark glaciers in different climatic settings. That will give you a continuous data sets on the real-time data set. Then another way to study these glacial system is to develop the models and do study by the remote sensing satellite imageries. So the satellite imageries gives you a variation of the ice cover. And then you compute it, how much is the changing in the total ice cover, how much is the seasonal snowfall, and then you compare with the data which you are generated on the field. So you verify those models, those changes which you are doing by the satellite imageries. So that will also help to quantifying the ice total ice cover, and we can manage our water resources more proficiently and more intelligently as we are doing now.
The studies will last for 5 years, after which TERI will recommend measures to bring down the glacier's recession rate. The observations and hydrological simulations from the Lidar and Sindh rivers are showing increased discharge trends due to increase in glacier melt runoff, and the snow cover has progressively declined in both the basins. Integrated study is focused on assessing the long-term impacts of the snow and glacier depletion, erratic snowfall in the region, and increased anthropogenic pressures on the ecosystem services, particularly the availability of water for drinking and irrigation in the Kashmir Valley. Only when we observe, understand, and then based on such understanding, work towards reducing this effect, can we secure life on this earth for us and our future generations.